Do you think physics will be able to really seriously address a lot of the climate change problems, global environmental problems?
Yes and no. In the long term, yes, but in the short term, it is a political problem. It is a matter of national policy. People have to vote. People have to vote for politicians that they think will carry out an ecologically safe agenda. That said, there is some glimmer of hope in the technology. First of all, why don't we have a solar revolution? We've been talking about it for decades, but the cynics say that only Hollywood millionaires can afford to make their house solar. There is a problem with solar. The problem with solar is not the solar cell, which everyone thinks is the problem. The problem with solar is storage, the battery. The economics of batteries are horrible. Batteries do not obey Moore's law. When the sun doesn't shine, the winds don't blow, you've just lost all your money. And so we need a super battery. You see, 100 years ago, Thomas Edison and Henry Ford were good friends, but they were rivals, and they had two different visions of the future. Edison bet on the battery to propel the car, while Ford thought it would be gasoline. Well, it's a no-brainer. Everybody knew who was going to win. Edison was going to win, because who wants to have your car explode with a hydrogen explosion in the gas tank, and who wants to have a gasoline station on every block? It was a no-brainer. Everyone said Ford's going to lose. Well, opposite happened. Ford won. Why? Because we do have gas stations in every block, and people die every day because they die in gasoline accidents, right? But with the super battery, and Elon Musk, by the way, is pioneering the super battery, prices are dropping 7% a year. And so there's hope that the economics of solar will begin to become competitive with fossil fuels. And then by mid-century, we hope in the ITER fusion reactor being built in Cardash, France. The European Union is bidding to store on a 10 billion euro fusion machine in which seawater is the basic ingredient for fusion power. But that's 20 years into the future. Every 20 years, we say that fusion is 20 years more into the future.